Listen, this is my day on Friday. Friday at 11 o'clock, I'm seeing Dr. Savannah, 43 Lakeville Road. At 4:45, I'm seeing Dr. Rosen at on Northern Boulevard or Lakeville
Road. All on the one
that
day?
Or becomes a social that they just...
You're lucky that you can get it.
No, because he's going to go on vacation. I was supposed to have it next week. The first 2 weeks of April are insane. After that, it's okay for a while.
But the PT takes over your life.
This is what I did this year. I have to tell you what I did this year. I boxed.
Yeah, me unboxing right there.
I was watching what you were doing, and I decided I'm going to do it by myself. And I said, I was boxing. I took up boxing. You said boxing.
So I'll teach you what I know. There's boxing.
No, because I don't have my bike, so I have my little PT. I'm doing this and this.
So boxing this way, then there's this way. Yeah. Like this.
I did the up. I was doing up. You said you have to look up on your fingers, so.
And you're sitting
when you're doing it, right? Or you're standing?
I'm standing.
Oh, you're standing because I'm sitting.
Well, either way.
Oh, I stood. No, that's the part of the time I stood.
The reason they want me standing is they want me to stretch my arm out and stretch my neck up, I'm doing tapping too.
I'm more worried about my husband today. Well, first of all, he needs a happy pill every day. But he doesn't have a happy pill. But he needs a happy pill.
I think he needs a happy pill.
It's very hard to be a cheerleader 24 hours a day. What do you call it? How'd you sleep last night? I don't know, who sleeps? He's doing the banking business. If I were doing the banking business, I wouldn't be doing the banking business. Because he does too many things at life. I take out money for the money. And so he does, he does a lot of things. He's doing, I don't want to go through that. He's doing my work. And yesterday, we went to the supermarket in the neighborhood just to pick up something. And I've seen the people in the supermarket running. Where are they running? They're running because Sandy fell. Where did he fell? He fell. Why would you walk where there's a safe area? You're not supposed to walk where there's a safe area. You're supposed to walk where they're doing construction. That's where you are. But they're doing construction. So he just trips. He didn't hurt himself, but he appears that he didn't hurt himself.
Oh, you're telling me.
But if he hurt himself, would he tell you, or would he make it like, no, not a big deal?
Oh, he would always say not a big deal. He would always say that. I'm telling him he's wearing shoes today that are going to get wet. Because I see my friend Mike, you can duplicate, and you can make a zero. The reactions and the things they say.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming. Thanks for making it out in the bad weather. So this is going to be a lovely program, which you can see written there on your program. And thank you for attending Chamber Music Live this semester. And we'll hope to bring back the series in the fall. And wishing you all the best. So thanks so much for your support and attendance.
Best to you as well.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all so much for being here today on this Wednesday drizzly afternoon. My hope is that today's program can bring a little bit of springtime sunshine and like memories of hopefully what's to come in the next few weeks as all the flowers blossom. I'm so lucky to be here today. Thank you to Marcy and Queens College for having me. And I'm so lucky to play with my wonderful pianist, Jaron Lee. And yeah. Yeah, just a little bit about the program. The Beethoven romances are a pair, and I thought of Tchaikovsky's Souvenir de Luncher because both of the Beethoven and the Tchaikovsky are originally written for violin and orchestra. So these are reductions for piano and violin that you're hearing today. And the Poulenc that we just played is the Bagatelle, and it's a really unknown work. I don't know of any, I've never heard it live before, but I was lucky to have the internet and browse and came across this little gem. So I'm glad we could share it with you today. And the Pulang Sonata is really just one of the most beautiful, heart-wrenching, whimsical pieces out there. And to close out the program today, we have an arrangement of a Rachmaninoff work by Fritz Kreisler, Daisies. And all of these works are sort of tied together with the theme of like love, romance, and I think hopefully we'll be able to share these expressions with you today. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
I saw it.